Sounds of Privateer FX. FOMC minutes today, inflation numbers, CPI out of America. This is a big focus. I just read now that the Chinese can pay $50,000 to shoot polar bears. Rather pathetic and sad article from Bloomberg this morning. Put me in a right bad mood. Anyway, let's talk about the currencies. Unfortunately, there's not a lot out here that we'd like at the open here. Let's talk about S&Ps yesterday. Wild day. 36 the low, 67 the high. Broke through the sideways in the bottom, broke through the sideways on the top. But we have ended up here on the bottom. And considering that there's going to be some sort of global response to Mr. Assad in Syria, the outlook, I would have to say, is still pretty negative. Selling low ones doesn't seem to work too well, so we're going to try and stick with selling high ones. We have the core, we have core short on still, we're trading delta, but if we're going to add to it, we're going to add up at around 2700. Because there is some good news mixed in with the bad news, and the people who are getting short right now at this stage in the bear market seem to have pretty weak hands there. So they're getting stopped out quite violently. Yesterday was a perfect example. Anyone who sold through 2640 immediately got destroyed up at 66, and you could kind of see that the market was just clearing stops on both sides. I have drawn this line here, which a lot of people are talking about. If you go into the 4-hourly, I guess it looks a little bit better. Some people are calling it an inverted head and shoulders. I draw it because everyone's talking about it, and because everyone's talking about it, it then becomes important. This is kind of technical analysis 101. What is the crowd going to trade? There will be plenty of people in the crowd who trade this, so they'll be getting long up to 2670. One of the reasons we're not going to sell high ones in the 6770 area is there will be CTAs buying through this level. We would like to initiate shorts around 2690 to 2700. So just be aware of this line. A lot of people talk. Yen doing nothing, we're just waiting for CPI. 107.50 is now important, nice little round number up there. On the downside, I guess 106.60, we'll see as we get closer to these numbers. First CPI and then FOMC. What else is out there? Not too much really. Dollar CAD looks a little bit overdone, I have to say. With oil going up so much, though, I guess dollar CAD could continue to go down, but this is now getting a little bit overdone. It's been a very steep move from 130, 120. Now we are at 126. It's a cool 500 points. I don't know. Be careful being short dollar CAD here. This is ripe for rebound, especially if we get hawkish dollar rhetoric from the FOMC, higher CPI, or equities get crushed. Dollar CAD will turn. Basically, just watching here at the open, if we see anything interesting developing before the U.S. numbers, we will let you guys know via Twitter. Otherwise, we are in patience mode. Good luck out there, guys. Ciao.